Thank you very much, Levan. Good morning, everybody, dear participants of the fourth forum of young politicians of South Caucasus and Ukraine. This is a great privilege for me, Chairman of the Parliament of Georgia, to host such audience in our facilities. I'm looking to you and I'm thinking about the future. If the fate of your own countries and if the fate of our common region was in your hands right now, I believe all the countries and the regions would be better off, because I see so many young, motivated people in this room, and this is probably something, the biggest achievement of our countries since our independence, because we are clearly witnessing the process where a new generation is taking more and more responsibility and is defining the future of our nations. So you are most welcomed to Georgia, to the Parliament of Georgia, and I want to thank representatives of Netherlands Institute of Multiparty Democracy for this wonderful initiative. And when we learned that they wanted to cooperate with us, with the Parliament of Georgia, of course, we decided to accommodate all your needs, the voting facilities, and also the staff of the Parliament will be ready to do everything possible in order to make your work productive, useful, and easy. I want to thank the Embassy of Netherlands to Georgia, who is providing always good support to this kind and other very important events. And I want to underline once again that the Institute of Multiparty Democracy of Netherlands is a very unique organization. And I experienced the benefit of this organization some early years of my political activity, because, yes, there was a time when I was a young politician as well. And then this institute provided very valuable experience how multi-party system should work and how society should function in diversity, and how these diverse political groups and social groups should be coming together when necessary about the best interests of their country, and how they are in constant debate, in constant competition, but they are not fighting to each other all the time. There are some boundaries, some frames for competition, and then decision-making, and then following those decisions. Unfortunately, these are some of the notable problems in our countries, South Caucasus, Ukraine, when sometimes politicians, political groups, political parties, we are too much convinced that we are right. We are too much sure that we hold the truth. And then in such situation, of course, it is very difficult to continue political dialogue, to continue debate over the policy issues and to find the right solutions. In this regard, I was complaining about Georgian political system for many years, that despite we ended the era of communism in our countries, we deleted from our constitutions the Article 6, which was saying that it's the Communist Party which represents true interests of the people. But we failed to delete this from our minds. And we created many political parties. We seemingly had or have multi-party system, but in this regard, sometimes the reality is that we have multi-communist party system, meaning that all the parties are claiming on the monopoly on truth. In such situation, we will never achieve the results we have for our societies, which is free society based on the freedoms and rights of the people, prosperous society, part of democratic world. It is not achievable if we politicians, young and not so young politicians, don't become able to realize this very, very fundamental issue. In this regard, this kind of forum and this discussion, where people from young representatives of political parties from different countries represent different parties, but now you will try to look to issues with some common sense, common understanding, with your background and your values and with your priorities. this, I believe, will be a good opportunity for you to continue your practical work in your countries. Well, the challenges we face in Georgia, in Azerbaijan, in Armenia, in Ukraine, in many cases are similar in general, because we are struggling in the process of establishing democratic institutions. Yes, some local circumstances enabled some of us to move forward in certain directions, others are more ahead in other directions, so it's very difficult to have just one comparative analysis and conclude that, okay, who is ahead, who is behind, and so on. Basically, we are struggling to overcome the post-communist past and end in a true liberal democracy. In this process, we Georgian politicians or Georgian society went through very painful events. This building where you are now, some 25 years ago, was epicenter of the civil war. And very first democratically elected parliament of Georgia, which ended communist rule and was very first multi-party parliament, which declared independence of Georgia. By the way, we have just few days left when we will celebrate 25-year anniversary of declaration of the independence, and tomorrow we will mark the date of referendum, which was conducted in Georgia about independence issue, and it was conducted in Abkhazia and South Ossetia as well, and that's kind of foundation for restoring the statehood of Georgia. But in about 6 months period from that very important events, we somehow managed to engage ourselves in civil war, and hundreds of people died, and the parliament was dissolved, president was pushed out, and we lost very important thing. We lost legitimacy of the power, and it took, well, I don't know, at least 10 years. From that time to restore all these things and to put together all the pieces which are necessary in order to feel that you are one nation, one society with state institutions and power system and so on and so on. Then we had other ups and downs in our development and reforms. And now I'm proud to be chairman of the parliament, which completed the process of association agreement with European Union. This was important, huge milestone for our country, and after signing this agreement and after ratifying this agreement, we feel that yes, we are true member of European system. We are, our place is in within the structures of Europe. Of course, there's lots of work ahead. There are lots of issues we need to deal with. We hope that in 2 months' time from now, or 3 months, depending on other circumstances, not on Georgian performance, we will finalize the visa liberalization process and Georgian citizens will be traveling in European countries without visa requirement. This is a huge issue for society. It's not just about travel. It's not just about passports and visas. It's about psychology. When Georgian citizens will realize that, well, they are not treated as strangers. It's like when you allow your closest neighbor to enter in your apartment without just knocking or something, you know. It's just attitude, the treatment. And when people who would probably not travel immediately to Europe without visa, staying in Georgia, but just thinking that, well, yes, I can do it, and I don't need any permission. They are not looking to me like that. This is huge psychological issue which will strengthen the self-confidence of the nation and of the individuals. Therefore, this is very important milestone we are going to achieve. Unfortunately, there are many other issues which are not solved. And ongoing occupation of Georgian territories is something which, of course, imposes lots of problems in every single direction. We feel it every day in every issue what we are dealing with. But we decided not to be prisoners of the situation. because occupation will be ended, Georgia will be free, and Georgia will integrate back those people in the common statehood. But at the same time, Georgia declared that unilaterally that we will never use force for solving those problems, because we know what wars and armed conflicts are bringing in current world, and we have more than enough examples around. Unfortunately, in our region, and when we are talking about these four countries and their representatives here, well, these issues are so painfully familiar. And unfortunately, as it was not enough for Georgians, Azerbaijanis, Armenians, now our dear Ukrainian friends are very familiar about such issues when we are talking about armed conflicts and innocent people being killed in such controversies and so on. So we current politicians need to do a lot in order to overcome these problems. I believe these priorities will be on your agenda as well. But without the help from our friends, from the international community, we are not able to deal with this kind of problems, because we need more knowledge, we need more experience from those developed countries, and we need their support, because not everybody in our region is ready to realize that we are independent, sovereign nations, and we have our sovereign right to make decisions about our future. Would it be joining NATO, or would it be building another pipeline somewhere, or would it be having a trade agreement to each other? Well, this imperialistic understanding of the world, unfortunately, remains largest problem for our countries. On the other hand, new threats emerged, like terrorism, which does not have any boundaries and nationality, and we need to be very strong, and when we need to strengthen our cooperation in these fields. So, from my own experience, I can tell you that this process of the developing democracy, which is the main subject of your gathering, is something, yes, never-ending process. When you work hard, you spend lots of time and energy and resources for achieving something. You achieve it. Let's say you adopt something very important law, which, let's say, brings rights of the prisoners on another level, for example, which is very important thing to make sure that human rights are observed in those very, very specific circumstances. And you say that, wow, I did that. But after 5 minutes, you realize that, oh, wait a minute, there's another milestone ahead, because it's not enough. You need to continue. You strengthen, let's say, self-government institutions, and you are satisfied that, well, we did something good. We decentralized power. Now local people have more rights to make decisions about their own problems. Yeah, that's great. But after one day, you realize that, oh, yes, but the other things are necessary again. It's about electoral system. It's about judiciary. It's about relationship between public agencies and private agencies. It's about, I don't know, everything. You cannot name any single issue which you can say that, okay, it is done. It is never done. It is never-ending process. Therefore, we should not be somehow becoming pessimistic when we look and say that, well, there are so many things which are not addressed yet in our countries. Well, in this, I believe our colleagues from Netherlands and from other countries will help us, telling that, yes, they are seeing mountains of problems in their developed democracies, which are still there and are waiting for right decisions of politicians and other involved people. So, I wish you all the success. I wish you personal strength. I wish you enough dedication in order to just make the world like you want to see it. I wish you to fight for that, but also I advise you not to forget that there are some other people just next to us who are doing the same. Therefore, we need to somehow cooperate in our attempts to change our countries and societies and the world. Levan mentioned that probably some of you will decide to move to some other professions and so on. My personal wish would be to stay where you are, to work hard, to get real seats in real parliaments, and I'm addressing it to Georgian representatives here as well. I'll be glad to see you in the next parliament if you decide. We have no problem about that. And we will be always ready to cooperate with you, with the Institute, with you, and be helpful in your attempts. Thank you very much.